गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आवर टॉपिक इज हिस्टोग्राम एंड दिस इज प्लॉटिंग विद पाई प्लॉट पार्ट टू। इन दिस लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस हाउ टू क्रिएट हिस्टोग्राम यूजिंग मैटप्लॉटलिब लाइब्रेरी। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल लेट अस टेक अ क्विक रिवीजन ऑफ ऑल द टर्म्स रिलेटेड टू पाई प्लॉट। बार ग्राफ, बार ग्राफ इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज अ बार, इज अ ग्राफिकल डिस्प्ले ऑफ डेटा यूजिंग बार्स ऑफ डिफरेंट हाइट्स। ओके, एंड दिस इज द टेबल, यू कैन इजली सी ऑन स्क्रीन। Favorite type of movie, there are five different classifications: comedy, actions, romance, drama and sci-fi, and these are the number of the peoples who like this type of movies, these types of movies. So if you want to print, if you want to draw a bar chart, so it looks like that. You can easily see that different bars are here of different colors. And now second question is, what is histogram and how it is different from a bar graph? So histogram is a type of the bar plot that shows the frequency or number of values compared to a set of value range. So that is the difference between the histogram and the bar chart. Histogram plot can be created with the Python and the plotting package matplotlib. So both bar chart and matplotlib, both bar chart and histogram can be drawn using matplotlib library. And for that purpose, there is a function named hist, H-I-S-T. Hist function is used for that purpose, hist. You can easily see on the screen, hist is a function. Created a histogram, plots, and that is the syntax of a histogram. Just write name of the library, plt, and then after hist, plt basically refers matplotlib.pyplot. Matplotlib is the name of the library and pyplot is one of the interfaces, which is a collection of different methods. Hist is one of them. And that is a complete syntax. Here you can easily see that. Just write plt in place of matplotlib.pyplot. After that hist, then x, then bins, by default bins is none. Cumulative by default it is false. Hist type by default it is bar. Align by default it is mid. Orientation by default it is vertical. These are the default values. If you don't mention these values, then default values are considered in that case. And x is a basically value by which we can draw a histogram. So let us take some example here. Basically, histogram is a graphical display of data using bars of different heights. Always remember the definition of the histogram here. And it is similar to the bar chart, but a histogram groups numbers into range. That is a basic difference between a histogram and a bar chart. It is similar to bar chart, but a histogram groups numbers into range. And the height of the each bar shows how many falls into each range. And you decide what range to use. And it is up to you that what range you will take for creation of a histogram. Now there are some key arguments here. First one is bins, list of the bins ages, the type of the list of the bins ages. You can decide bins as like that, 5, 10, 20 and 30. So it is up to you. According to that, bins can be decided or you can take equal value for all of them. Next, hist type. Different type of histogram can be created. It is using bar, by default it is bar. Stack, step or step field. These are the four different types of histograms here. Here if you want to just use bar, which is by default, then just write hist type is equal to bar. If you want to change the color of the histogram, then color is the name of the parameter. And here B, we write B here, B represent blue, and by default blue is there. If you don't mention any color, then by default color of the histogram is blue. Then age color, so this is a, if you want to define the age color, then for this purpose age color attribute is used. Here you can easily see that color is equal to K. So K basically represent black color, by default it is black, and alpha represent opacity. So just write alpha is equal to 0.5, which represent opacity. And we will discuss all these keywords argument in our program one by one. So let's specify our bins in 15 increments. Then this means our age will be like that: 0, 15, 30, 45, and 60. So you can also specify bins like, if you want to specify the increment, then all the values are like that: 0, 15, 30, 45, and 60. So there is the increment of 15 each time. Color B represent blue, K represent here. Age color is equal to K. Here one thing is should be noticed that here name of the parameter is age color. Age color. EDGE. Age color. Age color, not color. Color is basically used for the color of the bar, but age color is used for color of the age. Alpha. Alpha 0.5 means half transparent. That, as I told you, that this represent the opacity. So 0.5 means half transparent, and you can increase or decrease the transparency using alpha attribute. And you can also use X level and Y level. X level and Y level are the two methods used for representation of name of X axis and Y axis. And if you want to give the title of your histogram, then for that purpose, title method is there. Just write plt.title, and within the title, within the parenthesis, you can give the name of the title. Okay, so these are some other attributes. Now, let us talk about this practical implementation. First program is to create a simple histogram, and in this program, there is a default bin. Okay. So first of all, you have some data to create a histogram, and you can easily see that we take a variable name data, and there is a list, and list contain different elements, and we want to print a histogram. Then just write plt.hist. Actually, plt is a alternative name given to matplotlib.pyplot. You can easily see here. Matplotlib is the name of the library. Pyplotlib is one of the interface of matplotlib, and plt is the alternative name given to matplotlib.pyplot. So whenever you want to use matplotlib.pyplot, then just write plt in place of that. So here we just write plt.hist. Hist is the name of the function used to create histogram, and then after data. So histogram is based on that data, which is defined in our statement. After that, 8. So 8 bins are there. Okay, 8 bins are there. We just define 8, so 8 bins are there, and then after that plt.show. Here you can easily see that default bin is not there. We just specify the value of the bin here. So 8 bins are here, plt.show. After that, histogram will be printed on a screen. So lots of work are there on this screen. First of all, simple histogram. We just import matplotlib.pyplot here. Then data is given, and then hist function is used with data and default and use the value of bins is 8, and then after show function which show the output. This is the histogram. You can easily see that number of count number of the bars here: 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 6, 7, 8. And why it is so? Because in question we use 8 here. Okay, so data is divided into 8 different sections. 8 different sections here. And default color is blue. Why default color is and default color is blue? So if you don't mention any color, and we don't mention any color here, color of bar, neither the color of the age. So we can see here the default color is blue, and the color of the age is by default black. So black color is there. Black color is there. You can easily see that this is a black color. Black color is there. So this is a simple histogram. Next, orientation is equal to horizontal. By default, orientation is vertical, but if you want to define orientation is equal to horizontal, then for that purpose, there is the argument name orientation. So So just write orientation and give the value horizontal. By default it is vertical, so if you just write verticals then there is no effect when we compare it to the previous program. But when you just write orientation is equal to horizontal, then this will make some change. Let us see what is the change behind it. You can easily see that now orientation is equal to horizontal. And one more thing you can easily see here. Okay, same program here, same data here, plt.h, same function here, data base is equal to 8 here, and orientation is equal to horizontal here. So these are the you can easily see that 1, 2, 3 different, 5, 6, 7, and 8. So total 8 bars are here, because we just specify bins is equal to 8 in this question. In previous, when compared to the previous program, there is only one change, and that change is regarding to the orientation. We just put orientation is equal to horizontal. So when just we put orientation is equal to horizontal, then this is our output, and we can easily see here that in that case horizontal histogram is there. Next, opacity. If we want to change the opacity, for that purpose we can take a argument alpha. Alpha is argument defined to the opacity, and we just take opacity is equal to 0.5. means we can change the transparency of a histogram by using a attribute alpha. Now you can easily see that same program here, import matplotlib.pyplot as plt. So matplotlib, as you know, that is a library. Pyplot is one of the interfaces of matplotlib, and plt is here. Then we define a data, and whenever we want to use matplotlib.pyplot, we just write plt in place of that. So plt is there. After that, hist is a function, then pass the values data, bins is equal to 8. Similar in this case, you can also increase or decrease the value of the bins. So the answer will be changed according to that. And in this case, we just take another variable, another argument alpha. Alpha is equal to 0.5, means transparency is just half of that of the original one. And at last, plt.show, which will show you the output. And the values which are not defined, or the argument values which are not defined in this case, are considered as a default. For example, default color is blue, default age color is black in that case. Okay, so you can easily see that is the output. Now you can easily see that the color is little bit changed as compared to the previous one. So just look at the output of the first program. You can easily see it is the output. And in this program, we don't take any alpha value. We don't specify any opacity. But in this case, you can easily see that this output is less transparent as compared, much transparent as compared to the previous one, because opacity is equal to 0.5. So half transparency is there as compared to the previous one. So that is the use of alpha attribute. Next, if you want to change the color of histogram, that is also possible. For that, we use attribute named color. Always remember the spelling of the color, color. Color is not used here, color. And we can specify name of the color. We can also write the character for that color, if we remember that character for that color. For example, Y is used for the color yellow, G is used for the color green, B is used for the color blue, K is used for the color black, M is used for the color magenta. These are the different characters used for the different colors, and you can also represent, you can also give hexadecimal value or RGB value. You can also give hexadecimal value in that place. So first of all, we just write a color name here. Okay, rest as we, when we compare this program to the previous one, all portion of the programs find to be the same as that of the previous one. You can easily find out that same data here. Okay, same data here, but in this program we just increase the value of bins and we just write bins is equal to 10. Till now we just use bins is equal to 8, but in this program bins is equal to 10. So when we execute this program, there are two changes: total number of the bins, or we can say that the total number of bars in this histogram are total 10, and color of the bars are here is of yellow color. So rest all values are specified as, all value are considered as a default value, because we don't give any value to age color, or also alpha is also not there, so there is no transparency at all. So let us check it. You can easily see that is output. The total number of bars are here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. So that is the difference when it compared to the previous one, and you can easily see that the color is here is yellow color is there, because we just use color argument here and we just write y. If you just write red r in place of y, then you can also give the name, full name, or you can also use the character for that purpose. Okay, and one more thing to be noticed, that age color is black in that case. And why it is so? Because default age color is black. Now if we want to change the age color, then for that purpose, age color attribute, you can use age color attribute. So age color, we just take green, and for green there is a character G, so we just write age color is equal to G. So green color is there, green is the color of the age. And it's talking about the rest part of the program, you can easily see that it is almost same, it is same as the previous one, or what, there is a difference of only the one argument value, and that is age color, and here age color is green. So the output is same as that of the previous one, with only one difference: here age color is green, and the data values are same here. You can easily see that the first line is import matplotlib.pyplot as plt. So matplot is, as I told you, that is the name of the library. Pyplot is one of the interface of the matplotlib. plt is the alternative name given to matplotlib.pyplot, and import and as are two keywords here. Data is a variable which is basically a list containing different data items. And if we want to create histogram, then for that purpose hist function should be used. So we use plt.hist, and then data, this value is given first of all, which on the behalf of that data, histogram will be created, and after that bins is equal to 10. So total number of bars are bar is here are 10. Color is Y, so color of the bar are considered as a yellow, and then age color is green here. We already specified here age color is green, G represent green color, and then after last statement plt.show, which basically show the output of that program. So let us see the output. You can easily see that age color is green in this case. You can easily see that this is the age color, and the color of the bar here is green. So this is the output of this program. Next is we want to change the number of the bins. So what happens here, we just write bins is equal to 15, and as you can see here that same program is here, but with only one change. Here we just specify bins is equal to 15, so 15 bars should be there. or data is divided into 15 different categories. Here you can easily see that total number of bars here are 15. If you count all these bars, these are 15 here, and data divided is into all these 15 bars. And color is blue because blue is default. By default, if you don't specify any color, then blue color is there. And age color is by default black, so black is our default age color. And also we don't specify the value of the alpha here, so no opacity is found here. So these are the default values in terms of the color, age color and opacity, and the value of the all alpha. And total number of bins here are 15, so data divided into 15 parts, and range are reflected here. You can easily see here. Next is cumulative. This is very important in testing argument here. If you use cumulative, by default cumulative is equal to false, and if you just cumulative is equal to true, then data will be shown in cumulative fashion. Okay, so same data here as in the previous case, but we make here a single change here. We just write cumulative is equal to true. So when we just write cumulative is equal to true, so data will be shown in cumulative fashion. It means last value is added to the previous value is added to the next one, and after that histogram look like as shown on screen. You can easily see that. So this is the output when we just pass cumulative is equal to true. You can easily see on screen. And we compared the rest part of this program to the previous one. We found out that all things almost are same. There is a library. First of all, import the library matplotlib, then put interface name of the interface .pyplot, and give the alternate name to matplotlib.pyplot, which is plt in this case. So if you want to use matplotlib library, you just write plt in place of matplotlib.pyplot. Okay, and hist function belongs to pyplot interface, and pyplot belongs to matplotlib library, so we just write plt.hist function here. But before this, we have to give the name of the, we should create a list, and you can easily see that list contain different data items, and different starting from 15 and last value is 53. So plt.hist, then you pass a data as argument, and then bins is equal to 15, so data divided into 15 parts here, and then cumulative is equal to true, so 15 bars are also here, and cumulative is equal to true, so data will be shown in a cumulative fashion. And then after just we write plt.show. Without this you cannot get the output. You cannot get the output on a screen. If you don't write plt.show, our program successfully executed, but output is not shown in our screen. So it is mandatory to write plt.show just after the execution, and this must be the last line of your program. If you don't write this, then program will successfully execute it, but there is no output displayed on a screen. So if you want to display the output on a screen, then just write plt.show as the last statement of your program. And now you can easily see that is the output here. Output is in cumulative fashion. Next, there is a program, simple histogram, and now we just took two ND arrays, two different values here, data 1 and data 2. Okay, so what will happen in this case? So you can see that this is data 1 and this is data 2. And if you pass us two different values or two different values as a argument in hist function, just like in this case data 1 then data 2, normally we pass only one value. In all cases we just seen before, there is only just single data value here, but if you just pass two data value here, then histogram will show two different histogram will be shown for two different data values. So that is the difference when we compare this program to the previous one. Here there is only one difference, and the difference is there are two different data values. You can easily see that. So these two different data values are given in a square bracket, always remember that, not separated by a comma, because this is a argument here, and within this if we want to just define two different data values, so give these two data values in square brackets within parenthesis sign, otherwise error will be there. Okay, now you can easily see that. Now that one question is which is raised in our mind, that default color is blue, and here we see two different colors, blue and green. Obviously first value define data 1 and second value define data 2. This is there's no confusion in that case, I think. But why green color is there? Green color is there because we use two different data values here. So default color is blue, but here if you want to differentiate these two different data values, or Python just differentiate these two data values using two different colors, blue color is already there, so second default color is green. So if there are two different data values, then first is always represented in a blue color and second will always represent it with green color here. So two different colors are there for two different data set of values. You can easily see that. And just last, as I told you, that pld.show should be written to show the output of to show the output on a screen. So pld.show is there. So that is the output after the execution of that program. You can easily see here. Now just change the type of the histogram here. If you just type the change of the histogram, then histogram will be shown on screen according to the type. Here not type is bar stacked, so we just take the type of the histogram, bar stacked here. You can easily see here that same program here as that of the previous one, but only with some differences are here. First of all, bins is equal to 8 I specified here, and hist type is equal to bar stacked here. So two different arguments are mentioned here. Rest I think all part of the program are same as the previous one. You can compare this program to that. There are only difference in terms of the bins value and type of histogram here. Type of the histogram is bar stacked here. Okay, so when we just try to execute this program, then output look like this. This is the bar stacked histogram. This is one first value, this is second value. So there is a comparison between these two values. So this is because we just take type of the histogram as bar stacked. Next is cumulative is equal to 2. If you just find out, if you just give another value, cumulative is equal to true in this case. So wait a minute, So we just give bar stacked as a history type and cumulative is equal to true. Answer will be in cumulative manner. Means you always previous value is added to the next one. So that is the concept behind the So you can also use cumulative is equal to true with bar with hashtag bar stacked. So it is only depend upon you. So just try it. After that, cumulative is equal to true. You can easily find the output according to that. So that is today's that is all about our today's lecture, in which we can now in which we are we discussed all the topics or all the points regarding to histogram. So now I think you can easily create histogram using Matplotlib library. Thanks for watching this video.